Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eat and Run here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance Series. You all did it, Mosh Pit. We had a back-to-back double spot of 5,000 likes on this week's videos. Now, we're only one away. That means if today's run goes over 5,000 likes, we will be lined up nicely and neatly for All Blind Items Week starting tomorrow for, you guessed it, Random Run Day. Oh boy, it's going to be a lot of fun, and thank you all very much. I really appreciate the support, and I hope you had a great start to your brand new weekend here in the Mosh Pit. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by, I'm going to say Milurin or Milurin. I don't know what the thread was. It's hard to know the next. E. Yave. E. Oh, man. The fact that the logo can just be swapped with anyone's, like, cartoon head is just hilarious to me. Thank you very much, Milurin, and all 109 of you who upvoted that one. Whew, I've been playing a lot of Pokemon Kaizo lately, as everyone knows, so playing Isaac is definitely a little bit of a change of pace. Foxtrot Mike Sierra 9, Tango Zero Whiskey Zulu. I'm going to say we definitely badly need some movement speed, and we are going to get it. Definitely badly need some tears rate as well as some damage. Starting off with 3.22 damage, and 2.1 tears is not phenomenal, but not the worst that we've seen. But as you can see here, it's going to take five shots, no less than five shots, to kill things, and that is not a good start, I would say. We do have Book of Telepathy for Dummies as well, which is going to give us the Spoonbender effect on use. Only a two-room cooldown, so it's not too bad, but you know, it's something that leaves a lot to be desired, I would say. I did hear Dogtooth go off. Now, Dogtooth does give us a little bit of a damage upgrade, so I shudder to think about what our starting damage stat actually was without Dogtooth. And yes, that is a very scary thought to think that our damage upgrade is Dogtooth. Like, that is, it's a sobering thought. Obviously, need to be careful here with this champion, but also be aware of the shmoves from enemy spiders and flies and everything else in this room that's trying to kill us. So, important thing to note here in this room, and this is a great room for training purposes, if you are having problems with how the, particularly the spiders go, the little spiders give people, it seems like, the most trouble, the newer players. If you notice how they kind of like stick and move, like you'll see them like, you'll see them move, stop, move, stop, move, stop. Like, take a look at this spider right here. I can influence where this spider goes without him ever really touching me. But you see how there's a little bit of an interval in between when they actually move. When they stop, that is they are pinpointing the exact position that they are going to move at, and you are directing them. So you can really manipulate an entire room of spiders by paying attention to what's nearest to you and moving accordingly to where you have like a nice little escape vector that you don't have to worry about being pressured against in a corner or up against a wall or something like that, unless of course you absolutely have to. But it's very good to understand how that works, because if you can understand the concept of manipulating where the enemies go, you will be able to do everything that you need to dodge accordingly in the game. Same thing goes for trites. The trites, they lock on very, very similar, in a very similar fashion at the very same interval that the little spiders do. We could get like some money here, but the dips don't really work the same way as that. It's mainly spiders that will do the sort of like stick and move. And those are the ones that you can really manipulate. For dips and dangles, that sort of thing, you have to stay a little, you have to give them more of a wide berth. Mainly because they will just kind of slide afterwards. They don't just stop on a dime. We get a bomb here. I know that the super secret room is there, but obviously we're not going to use our only bomb because we desperately need some HP here. And we also don't know if there is going to be or if there's not going to be a Tainted Rock, which it doesn't look like there is. So now we can go back into the super secret room and hopefully get some kind of HP in there. Now you got to be careful. This is where the little exception is to the stick and move rule is that if they're stuck on rocks, they will move further than they're supposed to. I'm actually not going to use our bomb yet because there might be a Tainted Rock in here. My god. So we have a long and arduous process of taking down not a tanky enemy, but you know, I'm hoping that Pin just hooks us up here and gives us a nice damage upgrade. Obviously, we need to be a little bit careful because the little Ipecac shots that he shoots will deal one full heart of damage to you. Get just a basic upgrade, basic HP upgrade. And let's go back and use our Bomba to go into the secret room, which gives us yet even more red hearts that we can't do anything with. But now at least we can go in the curse room. That's something, right? Right? If we had an IV bag, we'd be very happy right now, but unfortunately we don't. I probably should use that bomb to get more options, but it really kind of illustrates like how lame super secret rooms have really turned out to be lately, especially like in recent memory. Like, super secret rooms really do kind of drop the ball when it comes to clutch playmaking. Like, you know, it is nice to get the womb room every now and then, like the one that we got here, but obviously it's not what we wanted. We wanted like an eternal heart or really just anything. We have enough to buy this. Hopefully there's a bomb. There's three bombs, actually. But now we still have a chance. Even if this gives us a nickel and we get a good withdrawal from the donation machine. And it didn't. It gave us butt penny instead. That's hilarious game. Appreciate it. Don't ever talk to me or my son ever again. We need 2 cents. We have two bombs. I know that there's a lot of pots over here. You might be thinking that this is not really all that worth it for more options, but I promise you it is, because more options gives us a second boss item. Just imagine the possibilities with a second boss item that we could wreak havoc on. And one final bomb, and it's going to be almost a prayer and a miracle now at this point if we end up getting these 2 cents. I did not hear any barking from Dogtooth. Oh, we got another bomb. The barking would have represented that there's a crawl space somewhere, which there was not. So, all right. So we have two bombs now. So we still have a very slight hope. We need 1 cent. Hope and a dream. We get 2 cents. Oh, baby. Yeah, so we worked really, really hard to get that, but at the end of the day, it was worth it. We did get kind of screwed by butt penny, but, you know, that's just how it goes sometimes. I'm very happy that we at least got more options. We're ready to head on to Zown. Curse of Lost. This is a really not great start, though. We lucked out that we did get Roid Rage in our item room. It's not really a super common starting item that you find in the first item room, anyway. Yeah, this is where the lack of damage is going to get us into a lot of trouble here. And we have to really be careful of the schmooves here from the dips. Yeah, maneuvering around with... We have adequate movement speed. Our movement speed is fine right now. The problem is that we just don't have the fire rate nor the damage to really cull the higher priority targets that are near us that may cause us to lose the devil deal. So, in other words, I've got to play pretty focused here, because we're already kind of in sort of like a precarious situation. And a sacrifice room would have been amazing on floor one. And all those red hearts that just go completely to waste. The trinket we have, by the way, is the broken lock, which will allow us to open golden chests with bombs instead of keys. But we have neither, so. And dead end. All right. Oh, the secret room's to the right of here. It doesn't really matter because we don't have any bombs. For these, I would say try to take down the already headless torsos first, just because they are going to limit your escape, your pathing. Also, don't walk into fire, pro tip. We get a couple bombs here. We know that the secret room's to the right of here. We didn't even need Dogtooth to confirm that, knowing that we had not this room, but this room right here. Two Yaves. All right, let's go to the right part of the
map now.
I don't know why those two flies decided to go down there. You see them pause and kind of like stutter for a little bit there, and I kind of don't like that at all. That's what I don't like about the green flies. But you're seeing the DPS problems that I'm talking about here. This is bad. We needed to get out of that corner before this champion did that. Otherwise, it was going to use these... It's going to use these flies like projectiles. And it did it anyway, so... We cannot afford a tears down right now. The allure is there, but the Sinvicta luck is also there. Alright, so we are in danger of losing our Devil Deal now. It was only a matter of time, really. With these stats, and we're just still looking for that item room. Yep. Just a casual 9-minute, 15-second floor. Yeah, it's all right. You know, Rome wasn't built in a day, and neither was an Isaac run, you know? Finally found ourselves our item room, and Shoop the Whoop. And Shoop is a welcome addition to the squad here, but Shoop does not really get us to where we want to be for the most part. We need to get a lot of help. Now, Blue Candle, on the other hand, is something that would be able to get us there. Blue Candle is blue awesome. I don't really care if we take damage in here at this point. We've already lost our Devil Deal. Gonna try not to take damage. Super secret room is to the north of here, I think. Love to get Blue Candle. That would save us a lot of heartache here. No, it has to be to the south of that room. Remember, the super secret room can only be adjacent to one and only one room. And, yep. I think we're going to have to abandon the idea of getting Blue Candle here. I'm going to go in the curse room just in case if we can actually get a couple soul hearts in here. Really risky, obviously, but... Yeah, so we're going to have to end up taking the soul heart, which means that we can say goodbye to Blue Candle. And to make it even worse, we don't have a full charge in Shoop to Whoop. Hopefully it's just regular Monstro and not champion Monstro. Flies, please. Flies. Flies. Thank you. A little bit of damage, but obviously we want every bit of chance here against Monstro. I mean, the faster we can get him down, the faster we can be sad about missing our deal with the devil and go on to the next floor. Unless we get lucky. It is Saturday. You never know. Never know. We might. Today might be our lucky day. We might get our second floor deal with the devil here. And it's going to be everything that we ever hoped and dreamed for, and everyone will talk about it throughout the annals of time from here on out to say, this is the moment. That Saturday, episode number 450, whatever this is, that was the time that man got so supremely lucky, we just had to make memes of it. And the world will rejoice in our new found meme lordish position. We actually did get it. We have to take a tears up here. And we get Guppy's Call and Betrayal. But hey, we got it. Yeah, we got it. Yeah. Maybe we can get Charge Baby. Okay. Still maybe get Charge Baby. Now, I could have checked the I could have checked the door to alt path right there, because sometimes there is a lot of money that's sitting in those rooms. But most of the time, I either A, forget, or B, deem it not really worth the key early on. So we need to get rid of Broken Lock here, because we don't actually need... We need our bombs. Broken Padlock. Although I guess it doesn't automatically take it from your... It doesn't automatically take it from your total. It just... You can, if you have the bombs, you can open them with the... The bombs instead, like explosions, so. Better than nothing, I suppose. Thankfully, we did get at least a tiers up, which is going to help out our DPS by quite a bit. That being said, we still really, really, really need to get a damage upgrade. A very powerful tier effect. Something along those lines. Just thought that we were clear on that one, but they split in just a way where I wasn't expecting all of them to do that at the same time anyway. Good. I couldn't go up here yet because this one that we're shooting right now, it would have taken like the world's most smartest path and blocked us in. Then we would have lost this bone heart, which we really don't want to lose right now. Already kind of pissed away one of our soul hearts, which we shouldn't have. The one we got from the range upgrade. Station 2 is pretty good. Doesn't give us stats, but it gives us damage anyway. Okay, we have 20 cents. Debatable whether or not that was worth our final bomb. I mean, time will only really tell once we're like done with the floor. Notice how Shoop de Whoop, it does indeed proc the Infestation 2 tier effect, which will give us an attack spider every time that we kill an enemy, as long as we use our tiers. It cannot create other spiders, unfortunately, although that would be amazing. Would be a little bit too strong. There we go. We finally get a red heart so we can fill this bone heart just in case if, get into trouble. Oh, you... Shot at the absolute perfect time. The statue there. I don't want to fire Shoop de Whoop yet until we get the green globin over here. There we go. Then we have to say Shoop de Whoop in order for you to get the 10% damage bonus. If you didn't know that by now, I don't know what to tell you. Super secret room is to the right of this room. Oh, what, you don't believe me? HD sure would be very thoughtful right now. Keeper Sack is even better. We get Keeper Sizzak, which is going to give us some Stizzats, thankfully, because we've got lots of money to spend. Well, not a lot of money, but hey, we just got the first damage upgrade that we could possibly get on this run. So, 4.74 damage, Keeper Sack, again, just continuing to show why it's just such a fantastically crafted item. They might be wondering why I did that. Well, the answer should be obvious, but if it's not, we have 3 cents. I'm going to buy the full charge to give us a little bit more stats. Unfortunately, it went to range, but hey, it's still a stat upgrade, and we needed something like that. Keeper Sack is a huge item for us. There goes Gertie Jr. And marbles or HP? I'm going to go HP here just because I want a little bit more Devil Deal fodder. And now we can go into the cursed room here. We're not going to make boss rush. Like, just forget about boss rush. It ain't happening. I don't mind going down to an empty heart here because we have a sun card and we're going to use it on the next floor, which is going to give us a full heart heal. I wanted to get that key, but I don't want to lose this bone heart. Alright everyone, 5,000 likes is all we need on this video. We are there. 100% there. For all Blind Items Week, lining up very nicely for tomorrow. Again, I can't thank you all enough for those of you who do go out of your way to like it. Leave comments as well. Comments are huge for the channel. They are absolutely massive. They help out channels just as much as likes do. I've been saying that, but yeah, it's true. Like, it all comes down to engagement. Keeping you guys and gals informed on how to support not only my channel, but like other channels out there, your favorite content creators here on the platform is, in my opinion, one of my responsibilities to, you know, help you know how to help out those people who make your lives better or enrich it in some way, shape, or form with all these videos here on YouTube. Ooh. Worm buddy, as I live and breathe. Worm buddy or worm friend is going to automatically grab enemies and basically bind them. Might even say it's going to be binding them. Thank you. I'm going to save this bomb in case if there is a penny-eyed keeper in the store. But Worm Buddy is going to allow us to essentially have a lot of crowd control for basically no effort whatsoever. And it's a very hard counter against a lot of bosses. Think of it like sort of like poor man's Anima Sola is the best way to describe Worm Friend, except he's a lot cooler than like any of us. Because, I mean, it's Worm Friend. Like, what, you think you're cooler than Worm Friend? I disagree. Sir or ma'am. Yeah, we're going to be buying premium items here and spending as much currency as possible, except for like moving box, because, well, I wanted the soul heart. You have counterfeit penny, which is going to increase the amount of money that we pick up by one every now and then. Ooh. There you go, worm buddy. Look at that. Even Peep jumping up in the air was not strong enough to escape the grasp of Worm Buddy. The damage is starting to look a little spicy, 6.44, and again, that's all. That is 100% all Keeper Sack. And we fail a 68% deal with the devil, and I'm going to take Bar of Soap. We're going to head on down, because we needed a Tears Up. I know the feeling, Isaac. I know the feeling. That's what Kaizo Pokemon has been doing. Kaizo Ironmon has been just shooting me the bird, just from sun up to sundown. Indecision there on me. We deserve to lose that half heart. Ooh. Yeah, so now you're seeing Shoop the Whoops are getting more powerful. Starting to become a little bit of a reckoning force here. Hope we get that penny back. Didn't. There's a crawl space in here. How did I know it's there? I didn't. Common cold, you know, it's more damage, so I'm gonna take it. There's no way we don't take more damage. Now, we don't need to bomb a keeper because obviously we have a 100% chance since we missed our 68%. Can't really complain too much, however, just because based on the fact that, like, you know, we got a miracle second floor deal with the devil. But that good grace is quickly fading rapidly, which is usually what quickly means. We need to get a good, solid damage upgrade here. The super secret room is somewhere attached to this big freaking room, but the problem is that we don't know where. And as I just got done talking about how I'm not a huge fan of super secret rooms anymore, or have I really ever been, it's not worth our only bomb to do so, in my opinion. I'm going to walk out, walk back in, reset the shot timers of the purple fires. Sometimes they can drop soul hearts, sometimes they don't. Musty blood, yes please. Musty blood is going to give us more damage based on how many enemies we've killed in the room. I know this is a dead end over here, but maybe not. I'm looking for more money so we can go buy the glowing hourglass just so we can get more keeper's sack buffs. Actually, this is looking like it is going to be the route for the boss. Empress card. Just because it's a free shoop to whoop, and I also don't feel like walking all the way over there. Again, another free shoop to whoop here. Fill up that heart. Ooh, it's gonna be Cage. I am gonna pop the Empress card here because we're gonna need the extra damage. Okay, good. We got the poison out. It's good. Worm Buddy doing its thing. What I'd like to see. That's what I like to see. Well, I mean, I don't like to look at Cage, but I like to see the big time plays. Look at that. Completely immobilizing Cage. Didn't even get out of the starting block there. I'm going to go booster pack. We don't need the range. Do a diamonds and a joker card as well as a world card and a strength card and a hierophant card. I'm going to take the strength card in case we need it for the devil deal, which we don't really. Whore Babylon, I mean, there's very little reason for us to take it right now. We'd be giving up basically all of our soul hearts, which... I don't know, man. I'd rather have my soul hearts, to be honest. Okay, let's use the reverse. First world card is going to give us a guaranteed crawl space. And we've already been in there, so joke's on you. I already knew that. Fall for it. Two of diamonds. This is going to allow us to take the glowing hourglass. Hey, that was effectively 4 cents right there, and I'm fine with that. But I think what we should do is we can spend one of these soul hearts that we end up saving from Horror Babylon to at least check inside of the curse room, and we get our second syringe item here in the form of euthanasia. Let's get a dice room. Thought that one was going to die of poison. You know, hearts. Yeah, we don't have a sacrifice room. Sixth room is going to be a D1 Hizzle. We should get more money than we would have been putting in here. Yeah, 18 cents. It's 36 cents. It's enough for two premium items, which is a good amount of stats, by the way, for Keeper Sack. So, not necessarily on this floor, and we're probably going to get a greed fight on the next floor, but c'est la vie. Yeah. Hey, we actually gained money there. I mean, teardrop charm would double our poison rate of common cold, but I don't really care. The poison procs whenever it procs. We don't need to replace a good trinket for that. Okay, so we're going to take a glowing hourglass. We're not going to replace Shoop to Whoop, however, although I do like glowing hourglass. Maintaining our stat ups here from Keeper Sack is the most important thing. So, and I like having Shoop. It gives us more damage. It gives us our clearing power. We can use it to insta-give a lot of really early floors here as we go into the mid-game floors. Then we're going to take our Joker card and finally head on to town. There's the darkness. Now, we're hoping that we really pass this devil deal here so we don't end up having to use our Joker card. Seagram should be south of here, normally. Oh, wow. Opposite end. Well, at least we can bomb our way. Ooh, that's good. We can bomb our way into the first room. Actually, we don't even have to because there's a greed fight in here. The fun little trick there, if you want to let the game kind of help you out for once instead of screw you over. Let the mega troll bombs in the curse room. You could see me. My brain worked properly today. You could see me and how I manipulated the mega troll bomb on the couple floors ago, but also there where you just basically curve them around and make them hit the center of the room, and then they'll just blow up the other. They'll blow the chest to you basically. So you don't have to try to sidestep the spikes. You don't have to worry about using a bomb to do the same thing. Is that a dime sound I heard? It was. Yeah, 11-cent dime. Can't beat that. Tinted rock over here, too. Unfortunately, we cannot get to it by any means. Yeah, we can't get to it. Not without flying. What's going on here? Shoot the... I didn't see the gaps there. My brain was very confused for a second. They were all just kind of stopped. Samson's Lock. We can actually take Samson's Lock. We're probably not going to need money anymore. They may be wondering how come I didn't take the left hand. It's because we have Keeper Sack and we want the extra money. We want the extra money for extra stats because that's what this run really needs right now. Look at that 0.41 damage upgrade from just buying a 3-cent battery. That is huge, man. I mean, that's so good. All right, well, there's the entire level, everyone. Now let's go back and find our item room, shall we? You know, it's a slow start when we're not going to make Old Hushy even if we wanted to by the time we haven't even fought Mom yet. We've also been getting some pretty hellacious map spawns, kind of like this one here. Where, yeah. Ooh. Glad for Gimpy. I mean, Gimpy is a good item. It gives us a chance to receive a soul heart every time we take damage from any source. It doesn't have to be any particular source. We could even do it off of a temperance machine if we wanted to. They may notice that our damage and our tears rate and our movement speed is going up and up and up. That is because we have less Bloody Gust. We also have Lusty Blood, but it has nothing to do with taking damage. Now we are definitely moving, and we have 6.66 tears. So Bloody Gust is just, it's one of those items that just, it gives you just good benefits. You know, it always shows up. Isaac. All right. Oof, man, that is depressing damage right there. What I should be doing is waiting on Shoop. I should be waiting to use Shoop before. I shouldn't use Shoop until after we kill some stuff in the room, like for Lusty Blood. Get Ocular Rift, which I'm not a big fan of. Yeah. Your room is almost always going to be north of this wall if you ever see it. You don't need Dogtooth to confirm that for you. That's how we get Polar Invincibility there. It's because we have no red hearts to trigger or to cancel out the effect. And was nameless. We don't really have consumables to use, and I didn't really want that red heart, so... Yeah. Great shot by Euthanasia there. And talking about sticking and moving with the spiders earlier on in the episode, same thing goes for eye lasers for the most part. Not always. For the most part, you can manipulate where the eye lasers shoot, but you got to be very quick about it. If you're not quick about it, you're gonna get clapped, and you don't want to get clapped. Ooh. Had to be quick in here because obviously you want to stack the damage of both Lokis before they can split. We go. Another tears up here in the form of divorce papers. And yeah, that is a way, way, way better use of our HP than Ocular Rift. And for an opportunity to get rid of our red heart so we can at least go down to Polar Invincibility again. Said yeet to that vortex statue there, thanks to Euthanasia. Secret room is probably to the left of the room we were just in. Look at this. Incubus now. No, it's actually not. To the right of the room? A little bit surprising. I'm gonna bomb the Rotten Beggar just to give us a slightly better chance at getting a devil deal here. So if I wanted to be like uber efficient, what I should do is kill a couple enemies and then use Shoop to Whoop. That would give us a lot more value and a lot more damage out of it. I'm not too concerned with doing that though, but just be aware that there is a little bit of an anti-synergy that I'm doing currently. Like now is when we can use Shoop to Whoop after we've like almost maxed out the damage bonus. There's a sacrifice room here, and I'm a little tempted to play the sacrifice room. We've got a decent amount of HP. I'm comfortable with the amount of damage that we have. And well, there goes one of our bone hearts, so. Kind of was hoping that we were going to be able to hold on to that bone heart for the sacrifice room. And usually the secret room's to the right of here, or to this, or the super secret room. Obviously it's not because A, Dogtooth didn't go off, and B, we've already been to the secret room. But notice this flat wall right here, and basically the entire room is pointing to that wall. If we didn't have Dogtooth, that would be my first choice for where the secret room is. Yeah, I don't know where these shots are coming from here, but they need to stop. Stop taking bad damage. Got a little bit of a buff there. I couldn't wait too long because I wanted to kill the other eye laser. Did not get our deal with the devil. You know what? It's Saturday. Let's get some spice with this run. I'm gonna play the sacrifice room. HP upgrade here would be very nice. Could also get into the boss trap room by going down to 1 HP, which I'm willing to do, by the way. Okay, that HP container is huge for us. Yeah, I'm not going to go in the curse room because we need this HP to tap on the sacrifice room. Now, what I'm hoping will happen is that Gimpy just goes ham and gives us a bunch of soul hearts. I mean, Glyph of Balance. There was a time where I would have said, that's insane. What are you doing? Why would you do that? But after we saw that one episode, ooh boy. Glyph of Balance knows how to bring smiles to my face. We get Scapular, which is real good. Okay, I don't actually want to lose this Bone Heart yet. Need to. I don't know if this is going to take a half heart, if it's just going to take the whole thing. Oh, just the half heart. Okay. Now I don't mind losing the Bone Heart. Get our key. Now before we... Oh no, this is the last one. Well, I don't really want to take these soul hearts yet. Because I want to go into the boss trap room. I'm also going in the curse room here. Gimpy did drop. Oh my god. Okay. Okay. Wow. Okay. Well, I'm still gonna go look and see what's inside the boss trap room. Can't stop me, game. Yeah. That is pretty pog. Now we need to get at least one soul heart to pay for the soul hearts that we're going to find in here. We go over here. Grab all these. And sure, why not? Right, never let them know what your next move is. E-Bizzle. Now, we're going to need to take some damage on this floor in order for us to get, like, what I would consider to be comfortable damage. That's where Bloody Gust comes in. Difficult to tell which one was firing there. Worm buddy, good job. Belly button. We don't want them bouncing off each other. That's where you get in trouble with famines, is when these kind of ricochet off of one another. It's double red Monstro 2. Wow, that Monstro leaping in front of that shot. With impeccable timing, I might add. Bizzle still loading up. Bizzle gives us a justice card. With these amount of tiers now, we're able to effectively sling euthanasia pretty much everywhere that we fire, like almost instantly, like without fail. And on top of that, we also have the poison tiers from Common Cold. So because our tiers rate is so high, we're just able to apply effective status effects without even really trying anymore, which is good. means that we don't have to be super duper accurate. Seagram should be to the left of here. 9 lives, which is going to give us our second Guppy item. There we go. And I say, in honor of us getting 2 videos over 5,000 likes, I wasn't really planning on doing a victory lap, but, you know, the opportunity presented itself with that sacrifice room. So I figure, why the hell not? Let's get this video to 5,000 likes, everybody. And we'll be ready, set, booming our way to all blind items week starting tomorrow, hopefully, for random run day. So let's do it. Second seed, Foxtrot Romeo 17, Golf Whiskey Hotel 3. Now, 9 lives, we can be a lot more risky than we normally would be. It was almost our third syringe, which would have been amazing. So no secret room yet, which is odd, considering the rooms that we've seen. Harlequin Baby. Yeah, sure, Harlequin Baby, you can join us. Why not? I have no idea which... I don't know if this is the secret room, super secret room. Not sure. It appears to be the secret room. Stopwatch. I'm taking this purely for the benefit of us to have... with us having Keeper Sack. Obviously, we don't need the stopwatch. Super secret room's to this right wall over here. We know that because we're only looking for the super secret room. And remember, it can only be adjacent to one and only one room. So it cannot possibly be to the left. It has to be to the right. E-Bizzle, now's your time. And a hermit card. Yeah. Take a tears up. Ace of Diamonds. Nah, we don't need the money. We've got a hermit card. I'm fine with that. Ain't no thing. Let's get ourselves a full charge here before we go into this big room. Ooh. Yes, I will take 4.5 volt for Shoop to Whoop. That is awesome. Diplopia. We can take Diplopia, but there's not really a reason to have it. This key is good. On transformation, we do get a mystery gift. We can use inside of the secret room, which is right here. Fat on mushroom. We'll take Fat on Mushroom. Hoping that we were going to be able to come across some kind of mapping. I am going to take Diplopia and use it for our angel deal, or a devil deal, rather. Because there might be a good damage upgrade or something in there that we would want. Or possibly Fallen. Fallen's going to give us 2 items. Guppy's Paw and Spear of the Night. Can take both of these here. Now, obviously, we didn't need Spear of the Night for the flying, but we needed it and wanted it for the spectral tears. It's really what we're after there. Crawl space in here. Small rock, which I will absolutely take because our movement speed is very good. If this is a 4 room, it's not. It's a forget me now. Okay. Well, we can go back and get Shoop to Whoop after we go to our item room. If you're wondering why the door looks like that, it's because we have pay to play. And that allows us to open up doors and chests. Basically anything that requires a lock now, we can, or a key, we can now pay for with a coin instead. But it looks like a little coin slot instead of a keyhole. Buy the bomb. We get 0.28 damage just for buying a bomb, dude. That is just... that is the bomb diggity. Spectral tears are going to allow us to shoot through environmental objects. Which is going to be very, very good for helping us out. If we needed to, for some odd reason, hide behind something, which on this run at this point, we definitely do not. But it's always good to have. It's just for a convenience thing. Well, I mean, a couple days ago we had one where, you know, is Sharp Straw still good? And yes, it is. It's still very good. Very good. Even though I know that we dropped it, it helped us out through the beginning of that run. It's still very, very, very useful. Fish head. Don't really need fish head, but we'll just take it anyway. That's just instant AoE. Instant AoE death. We get car battery as well. The more damage we get, the more damage Sharp Straw is going to do, just like that. Just like that. Wow, that is such an impressive amount of damage, man. And you saw all the spiders and everything that was created thanks to Infestation 2. The reverse Hierophant, which is going to give us a bunch of soul hearts. Oh my lord. What do I love seeing in this room? Okay, so we're back up to 97 cents already. I will take restock. Might as well buy the Dull Azer Raid, and we get a treasure map. Okay. Sure, we'll take member card because we got money like that. Found soul, brimstone bombs. Sure. Don't really need Gimpy again. I think it can join, but we have two incubi. I do want red stew. So wow, we just upped the pain on this run. We'll take tropicamide, or eye drops rather, not tropicamide. And on down, I know that we skipped the item room, but we can get that on the way back. A spoiler alert, we're going after old Beastie. I wonder if we can keep the red stew buff to old Beastie. Keeper's can is fine. That's kind of a tall order though. That's a long, long way to go. The golden bomb here. It kind of stinks a little bit in comparison to Shoop the Whoop. I mean the Sharp Straw, because we can't rattle it off just back to back to back like we can with Shoop, thanks to 4.5 volt. Yuppie's Eye and Back Altar we do not want to use. I'd rather hold on to our Incubus, and I also don't want to lose D-Bizzle. If there's enemies that exist that we can't see, we just simply use Sharp Straw and just nuke them all. Hopefully the shop is on the way here. If it's not, no big deal. It's more about trying to keep the red stew buff alive to Beastie. which is, again, going to be kind of a tall order, but if we keep killing at a decent pace, we might be able to maintain it. We creep just kind of teleported up there. We hit him so hard. We get spun as well as synth oil. Oh, man. Yeah, this is starting to get out of control now. And I mean, not out of control, but we are really, really piling on the pain here. Yeah, we just one-shot all the gurglings with sharp straw. That's how high our damage is right now. Which is very, very good. That's where you want to be damage-wise. When the game just has to give up, that's when we're talking about the good stuff. I am going to do boss rush because I do want the extra items, and it's not really going to be that much of a problem just because we can kill so fast. Take the Polaroid or the negative for damage. I'm not going to take Brimstone. I think that would actually ruin everything. And I also do not want chocolate milk, so I guess we're just not going to do boss rush. Sure, Will Spear. See, we're actually gaining. We're actually helping out the red stew buff right now. Double dog tooth, because why not? And again, we can come back for the item rooms. It's not a huge deal that we're skipping them here. Let's see if we can get to Old Beastie before the buff runs out. Old Beastie. We know that she's going to be over here. That is a absolute reckoning amounts of damage. Emperor card. Try to find the shop here because of Keeper Sack. I don't care about losing the Soul Heart. I think we're going to be okay without it. Maybe the item room. No, it's not. Use the Emperor card and head on in. Still ticking away, but we might be able to pull it back.
It's gone. Just get over it.
What do you mean it's gone? How can you have spent our savings?
I will take the cancer item, not the trinket, the cancer item, which is going to give us the wafer effect if we take damage. Very good for late game stuff. Specs doesn't really matter.
He's self-destructive and disturbed just like his father. Look at who he has to look up to.
Shut up.
That red stew ticking back up.
We'll be fine without you.
I don't even remember what floor we got red stew on.
You need to confess your sins and become saved. Let his light inside you cleanse your soul.
You are taking this too far. Did you hear how that sounds?
Pray for your salvation. Come, pray with us.
Damage is sitting at 2.0, so we really brought it back here. I've been taking a lot of damage because I'm just walking through everything, but trying to see if we can actually make it to Old Beastie. Was that a floor one red stew? Can we make it? I think we are going to make it. Yeah, so we are going to make it to at least Dogma with the red stew buff.
Please don't leave us.
Hatchstick is going to give us some soul hearts. We also get 3 soul hearts back here, which is again the reason why I don't really mind too much about just kind of recklessly, you know, walking through everything. We don't need the HP. We're gonna be completely fine, I promise. Unless we use the Soul of the Lost. Then we're talking about a little bit of problem here. So thank you, everybody. I really do appreciate everyone coming out in droves to help out the channel and get us back on track for the like streak. We gave up our Polaroid, by the way. That's the reason why we don't have invincibility. Warm Buddy absolutely bullying Dogma. I actually didn't even know where Isaac was there. But there we go. We got to Beast with the one and only one red stew buff that we had. And let's witness the destruction here. Sharp Straw is going to make Beast's life a living hell. Which I guess, like, she's already kind of down here, so maybe she kind of likes it, I guess. That one Tractor Beam would be really, really helpful. Soul Heart there, courtesy of D-Bizzle. We're just slamming tons of damage into the enemies immediately as soon as they appear on the screen. I don't know if Death is down there anymore or not. He's somewhere down there. There he is. And there he goes. Now remember, we're gaining more damage here thanks to us having Lusty Blood as well. They get up close and personal, Old Beastie. And we have Brimstone Bombs as well, and it's, yeah. Yeah, it's not going to be good for Old Beastie. It's going to be good for us, though. It's going to be good for you by clicking that like button. Of course, subscribing if you want to see more videos here daily. Of course, thank you all very much. I really, again, one more time, I appreciate it. Looking forward to hopefully starting All Blind Items Week tomorrow. If this video gets 5,000 likes, I'm going to be watching it very closely. So until next time, keep it metal and be cool to each other, everyone. Thank you again for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, happy Saturday, and so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like The Revenant, Chocolate Milk Guy, Nicholas Fernald, Nathan Tollefson, and Austin Parente. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of the Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/sinvicta.